Hey there, everybody. Welcome back to our next project. This is A in STEAM, so that stands for art. Basically, all we're gonna be doing today is making salt, glue, and food coloring, I guess, art projects. I don't really know what else to call them, but let's get into it and you'll see exactly what I'm talking about.
So as for supplies, all we're gonna need is our salt, we have our glue, we have some food coloring, and we have about 3 pieces of copy paper in there.
All right, so our first step, let's just go ahead and take everything out of our bag. Now that we have everything out of our bag and we can see everything that we have our 3 pieces of paper, our food coloring, glue, and salt, go ahead and put your salt, glue, food coloring to the side. And let's go ahead and grab all 3 of your pieces of paper and let's stack them together to make them more thick than just a single piece of paper. Now I'm stacking these 3 pieces of paper together because we're going to be making a design on it with glue. And obviously it's gonna be wet and it'll probably bleed through just 1 piece of paper. So our other 2 are mainly just backers. So let's go on to the next step. All right, go ahead and grab your glue. Now this part is basically where you get to pick any design you want. I'm gonna go ahead and go with a jellyfish, probably like from SpongeBob SquarePants, just because it's super easy. It's wiggly and it doesn't really need to be very symmetrical or it doesn't really need to look good necessarily. Because it's just a blob. So let's do that. Go ahead, like I said, grab your glue and start thinking of your design and go ahead and start gluing. Now that I have my ugly, ugly jellyfish drawn with my glue, now it is time to grab your salt. Hurry before your glue dries, and you're gonna wanna pour your salt all over your glue just to make sure your salt sticks to your glue. Now that I have my glue design completely covered with all of the salt, you'll see there's like a ton of salt on here. You really need to really cover it because you want to make sure that as much salt will stick to the glue as possible. You don't want to do just a light coat because your food coloring won't stick to your salt if that's the case. So again, make sure you really cover it. Make sure you get all the glue covered. Now, at this point, we have to wait just to let it dry before we put our food coloring on, and that's about it. And as for time, like waiting for your glue to dry, I'd say wait about 10-15 minutes at most for this amount of glue. If you put more glue than I did, I would say wait about 20-30 minutes. But yeah, other than that, let's just wait for our glue to dry and get to the next step. Alrighty, so I waited about 20-25 minutes, honestly. I waited longer than I was actually supposed to, and it seems to be still kind of wet. So I am actually going to wait like about 20 more minutes, and that should dry it up. So let's go ahead and do that. Alright, now that we waited about 30 to 40 minutes, it seems pretty dry. So basically now, at this point, all we're really going to do is dump all of the salt off of our paper, all the extra salt. Don't worry if it gets on your table, it's okay, it's just salt. You can just wipe it up and clean it up, put it in the trash can at the end. So let's go ahead and do that. Now, as you can see, I made a huge, enormous mess with salt. Try not to do that, honestly. I had to pat it out pretty well because the salt and the glue had kind of bonded together really well, and it was kind of just covered with salt. But now that you can see, I have my design. All the salt is on the design itself, and it's all there. Now it's time for the food coloring. All right, now that I cleaned up all my salt, and our food coloring step is next. Grab your food coloring, of course. Now this isn't gonna be the best paper to use this on. Honestly, construction paper would have been a whole lot better, but it is what it is, it's okay. It doesn't matter, it'll still come out looking pretty okay. So go ahead and start with one of your food colorings and just add it wherever you want. Alrighty guys, I know this isn't the most pretty thing, but this is basically it. It works a whole lot better, to be honest, on construction paper, like black construction paper. That way you don't really see all the food coloring that spreads around it. But if you can look at it and you if you watch while you're dropping your food coloring on your salt, you'll see that once you drop your food coloring actually on the salt, it'll just spread within the salt line. So it got a little messy around here, around these bottom edges, but other than that, I mean, it came out pretty okay. So let me know if you guys got any better results. Maybe try spacing out the design a little bit more. That way it's not so cluttered around like the smaller areas, like around here and here. But other than that, guys, I hope you guys had fun, and I will see you guys next week for the M on STEAM.